a businessman you look up to?
You know, in different ways, I would say Elon Musk, in his ability to do multiple things at the same time with equal sort of fervor and passion, and to Jeff Bezos on his sort of singular focus on making a company successful. Very different sort of approaches to you know, building a company. In the Indian context, I would say people that have sort of been a you know, in some ways more from a reading than anything else, G.R.D. Tata in defining values and sort of sticking to values, which I think has you know, done the whole group proud, and I think the country has also benefited longer term from that. And then in a very different context, I would say you know, in the current market, you know, a bunch of these entrepreneurs and the courage that they're showing in what they're building.
A startup that you feel has been growing steadily, slowly but steadily?
There are quite a few of those. In our portfolio, we have this company, Suminter, that does organic exports, very solid business, working with farmers all across India, and has, you know, continuously kept adding farmers just because they, you know, pay on time, they buy the best produce and so on. You know, we've seen companies like Sedimac, which is engine control units. So these are very nuts and bolts businesses, I would say, that have just, you know, built a sustainable business model from day one and continue building that. So, you know, those two, from my personal portfolio, I would say, have done that, yeah.
Color you would wear to an official event?
You know, light blue is my favorite color. So, see, because I sort of see that.
Okay. Your inspiration?
My parents, in you know, my father's a doctor, extremely ethical in everything that he does and the way he's brought us up. My mother on her strong sense of family values and on getting you know, keeping us together, and then finally my wife, who is I think incredibly bright. She is very successful in her own right. And you know, I think she keeps me honest and straight.
Okay. Books or movies?
You know, no Hindi movies. I don't watch Hindi movies. But otherwise, a good movie is you know, English movie is what I prefer.
Okay. Cars or bikes?
Cars for sure.
Okay. Favorite book of an entrepreneur you still cherish?
You know, I said I movies over books. So I wouldn't be able to sort of remember, but I've read the biographies of Steve Jobs and of Elon Musk recently, and J.R.D. Tata's book earlier and so on. So I think there's a lot of books. You just pick up things from different people.
And weekends for you are?
Chilling out at home, hanging out with my two boys, and playing sport.
Technology for you in the coming years?
You know, if I look at enterprise technology, it's open source and SaaS. Consumer technology is everywhere, and it's going to be completely driven by data. And we are going to see more and more intelligence around us. And we just need to be ready to be able to use it in a productive and you know, in a pure manner. I you know, the risk you run with technology and intelligence is that it can be misused in many ways.
A thing in your wallet you cannot live without?
A thing in my wallet that I can't live without. Boy, this is... I've had situations where I've had no money. I've had situations where my credit cards have been maxed out. So I think you find ways to live without a wallet at times. In today's day and age, I think having an ID card is absolutely essential to get in anywhere. You want to check into a hotel, you need to show your ID card. To get to the airport, you need. So you just, you know, you can sense that I travel a lot. So I think an ID card is very important.
And India is a country for startups.
I think India provides a lot of opportunity because the inefficiencies in our ecosystem are huge. And, you know, what is the job of an entrepreneur is to recognize the opportunity that those inefficiencies present. And so the key thing is find a market which is large enough, where the inefficiency is glaring, somebody hasn't solved it. And if you can find a solution that is clear, that has clear value, then there are customers that will pay for it. So one of the interesting things is that, you know, we keep talking about the fact that farmers want free power or want free water and so on. But if you go into the hinterlands and talk to people, they're willing to pay as long as they get good quality product, right? So I think the more important thing now is for people to recognize that you provide the right quality, people will pay.